Good morning, students. Welcome to English classes. Today we are going to discuss a poem named The First Tooth, written by Charles Lamb and Mary Lamb. Let's start with the poem. Through the house, what busy joy, just because the infant boy has a tiny tooth to show. I've got a double row, all's wide and all small, yet no one cares for mine at all. He can say but half a word, yet that single sound's preferred to all the words that I can say in the longest summer day. He cannot walk, yet if he put with mimic motion out of his foot, as if he thought he were advancing, it's prized more than my best dancing. Let's see the vocabulary, the meaning of words. Double row means teeth in upper and lower jaw. To mimic means to imitate. Motion, movement. Tiny, small. Infant, a very young child or a baby. Prized, awarded. Now, let's see the paraphrase of the poem. Actually, this poem is written in the form of a complaint by an elder boy about his younger one. So, when the younger one was born, the elder one is not given much attention by the members of the house or this household. So, that's why he has a complaint. First of all, the younger one got a tooth, the first tooth. Then all of them give much care about the younger one, but not about the elder one. And the second one, that even though he can speak a lot of things, he is not given much care, but the younger one utters some sounds that is given much importance than anything else. And whenever he makes a movement, by the time it is much appreciated than the elder's dance. So this is the scene. So let's go with the poem. Through the house, what busy joy, just because the infant boy has a tiny tooth to show. Have bought a double row, all's white and all small, yet no one cares for mine at all. So the first complaint is that the house is really busy, and after it started to be busy after the young one's birth, and now he has got a small tooth. And even though I have too many upper as well as lower teeth are there, but at the same time the household or the members in the house, they don't care about me, but they talk about the first tooth of this infant. The next one, he can say but half a word, yet that single sounds preferred to all the words that I can say in the longest summer day. So even though I would be making the longest sentence or saying an entire paragraph, but at the same time no one cares about me. But when the infant, this small child, talks or utters small sounds or words, they give much importance to him than me. Then the last part, he cannot walk, yet if he put with mimic motion out of his foot, as if he thought he were advancing, it prized more than my best dancing. Whenever the infant makes small movements, by the time all people in the house, they give much importance to this infant, and they crowd around him and just watch the baby as if he is just making big movements. Even though he would be making one or two steps, but at the same time all people in the house, they are just behind the smaller one. They don't give much care about the bigger one. Even though the bigger can dance, the elder one can dance and do his own work, but at the same time none of the family members, they give importance to him. So this is what the complaint by the elder one about the younger. So please go through the poem once again, read it, and try to understand the meaning. Thank you. I would like to wish you a nice day.